To me, the bike experience is giving people with a disability an opportunity to ride a motorcycle again. It's brought motorcycling back into my life in a really big way, and if you were to ask my family, they would say that I have a stressful professional life, and coming to do this has made that balance. It's given me a balance in my life. And the balance comes from seeing the smile on the guy's face when they take the helmet off for the first time after they've launched. You know, that's, for me, is worth everything that we do.
After 2 years of being off a bike, or 30 years, to see their expressions, the tears in their eyes sometimes, often the joy of their family, because they've done something, again, they never thought they would do.
There is so much opportunity for you to smile and to live your life and to love your life.
Well, the bike experience has had an incredible journey. We started April 2011, and it was really an idea that was thought up between Talon and Russell, and it was all about getting disabled riders back on a bike. People like yourself that have experienced an accident but still love and are passionate about motorcycles. So we started with one guy back in April 2011, and since then we've had over 40 riders back on a bike.
The format for the day is quite simple. Our riders will arrive about 9 o'clock in the morning. From then they'll be briefed and they'll get dressed into motorcycle clothing, so they have full leathers, full face helmet, gloves and safe motorcycling boots. We'll then talk them through exactly what we're going to do throughout the day, and we'll do a demonstration of riding a motorcycle with Talon. The first movement we do is a straight line launch and retrieve of the rider. So we send them off, they learn how to use the clutch again, learn how to feel the accelerator, particularly for those riders that haven't been on a bike for a number of years. This is a really important first step. We do all this in a safe area of the paddock at Castle Coombe. After we've done the straight line launch and retrieve, we then set a small circuit out in the paddock area with slow speed manoeuvring, again just to get used to riding a motorcycle again. After that, we have a quick debrief from that session, which is led by our chief instructor, Graham. And then we move to the circuit. We have a 1 hour window of the lunch break at the Castle Coombe track day to take our riders out on track. The purpose of the track session isn't to do as fast a speed as you can, to go as quickly as you can around the Castle Coombe circuit. It really is just to get the riders back into riding a bike in a safe, controlled environment.
The idea that we wanted, or the concept that we wanted, was to make the bike look as little adaptive as possible, so that when the rider is circulating around the track, to the casual observer, you wouldn't notice the bike had been adapted, or you wouldn't even know that that rider might be a double leg amputee, might be a paraplegic. Yeah. So we start off with the toes, the feet. A lot of people who are paralysed have no control over their feet, so they need to be kept in place. Now, we've added, very simply, an old fashioned bicycle toe clip to the peg and put Velcro on the actual plate of the toe clip. And then we duct tape Velcro to the toe of the motorcycle boot. The peg actually takes the weight of the foot, but then this little old-fashioned bicycle toe clip with the Velcro just holds the foot in place so the foot doesn't slide off. The next stage is the knees. Obviously, their legs can flap around a bit. So what we've done is we put a long sort of Velcro strap onto the side of the tank, and we've stuck that against it, and so there is a tail that sort of sticks out at the front, and that simply wraps around the knee and goes onto the knee slider, the Velcro patch where the knee slider was, and that stops the knees from, or the body from being thrown forwards under braking, and stops the legs from being pulled out to the side. In order to change gear, simply have an electronic solenoid, which is an electronic gear shifter, and that obviously is attached down by the foot operated gear lever. Wires run up to the handlebars where there is a simple red and a green button, and that is all you need to do. Red to go down, green to go up, and pull the clutch in and change gear, and that's all you need. So it's really those three adaptations. In 2003, I was a motorcyclist that got knocked off his bike, run over and paralysed from the chest down. So I've been there, I've been at the bottom, I've been in the pit of despair. I felt the anger, I felt the frustration, I felt the resentment, I felt the loathing for what's happened. I felt useless. I've had all of those negative thoughts. I've experienced them, and I still do. Yeah, I still have my moments when I dip down. But I know that life isn't always about being rock bottom. Yeah, our life goes in cycles. And so sometimes we're at the bottom, but that only means that you're going to climb back up to the top. And through getting back on a bike, I have certainly gone right back up and beyond. And I know that it can change you around. So yeah, it's tough. And the rest of your life will be tough. But there are going to be some fantastic moments out there. And even if you might not believe it right here, right now, I can put my hand on my heart and say that there is so much out there. There is so much opportunity for you to smile and to live your life and to love your life.